Good afternoon, guys! Welcome to Life Apollos, home of the most trusted beard and automotive news. Happy to have you here! Today is gonna be a very different kind of episode, guys. We're gonna be covering some stories that are just some of the weirder, more unique stories we've ever covered, at least over the past 6 months or so. Talking about some predictions we made over the last couple days coming true in a very, very big way. We're gonna talk about Amelia Hartford's blown C8 Corvette and the very interesting side effect that has happened since the day she posted that video. Super cool piece on that. And yes, the big one, guys. Apparently, I was sent a very long message by an individual claiming that he was the one that impersonated Stradman and made all those offers and all those crazy hypercars that we just heard about in the massive video now from Stradman, his message to the identity thief buying cars in his name. Get ready, guys. Here we go. All right, first up on the slate today, guys, we're going to talk about a very weird phenomenon that has started to happen ever since Amelia Hartford posted that original video about 6 or 7 days ago on her twin turbo C8 sort of blowing up, for lack of a better way to describe it. All right, guys, we'll start with the obvious. The first two videos that she did on the subject of her Corvette having that monster issue netted her over 1 million combined views just with two videos. That's substantially higher than anything she normally does on the channel, even taking into consideration that a lot of her bigger C8 vlogs had done well into the 300,000 view range. It only gets crazier from there, if you can believe it. Since she posted that original video, in the last 7 days, Amelia Hartford's channel has gained 25,000 new subscribers just in 1 week's time. Now, as you guys can probably guess, 25,000 subscribers in a week is absolutely bonkers numbers, guys. Even on some of the biggest automotive channels during their biggest growth spurts, we're talking like 70 to 80,000 in a month. You know, if Amelia were to stay on track with this, she'd be on track to have like 100,000 new subscribers in a month's time. Truly incredible numbers. Obviously, nobody goes out with the intention to sort of wreck their car, but this is obviously a huge video series for her, and I imagine will sort of propel her to even greater height than we could really imagine over the course of the last couple months. And if you'll remember, we sort of pegged Amelia Hartford as one of the rising stars in the automotive world about a month ago or so, I think it was, talked about how, you know, we would easily see her hit over 1 million subscribers if she kept on her current path. This week certainly doesn't hurt that argument whatsoever. I'm sure she's not happy about her C8 having major issues with it, but chronicling the process of the repairing for that car and sort of rebuilding the engine, I think is going to just push her channel to monster heights. So obviously, congratulations on the brand new subscribers, Amelia. Sorry about your car. Hopefully you make the best of this situation and continue putting great content forward. All right, guys, moving on. Our big story of the day, and just one that I had to really think about talking about before we actually did. So let's talk about Stradman's previous video uploaded 2 days ago, kind of how crazy that was. I'm sure most of you guys have already seen that video, but if you haven't, the summary is essentially this. So in a nutshell, guys, essentially, Stradman made an entire video, probably well on its way to 1 million views at this point, pretty big video, that was a message to the identity thief, as he called it in his title, going around buying cars, making offers on different hypercars in his name. The individual would essentially email different dealerships using apparently Stradman's contact information and sort of put in cash offers for certain cars. Now, before we dive any deeper into the story, I want to start off with two major disclaimers. One, I sent a screenshot of this message that I received from this person claiming to be the impersonator to James directly well before we started making this video. And two, there is no way for us to 100% verify that the message that I was sent was 100% true. But here's why I think it might actually be real. All right, guys, so now that we have that out of the way, let's talk about two very interesting things that were said in Stradman's video, and then we're gonna compare it to the message that I was sent. For one, guys, James obviously pretty bummed out about this entire ordeal. I can't imagine what it's like to have somebody impersonating you and sort of making offers in your name, especially when you're trying to make one of the most important car decisions you're ever going to make in your life, buying your first hypercar, something that most of us can only dream about. And this sort of getting into the way of that can't be fun to have to mess with at all. All right, guys, so after the 7 minute mark in James's video, he starts talking about who he thinks is probably doing all of this stuff in his name. And it's actually pretty important what he's talking about. Have a listen.
So I'm assuming that whoever doing this is probably younger, you probably have good intentions, but please stop.
So obviously thinks it's someone younger, thinks it's someone you know, with the best of intentions, but obviously making a lot of trouble for him. And then here's the more interesting part, guys. If you take a look at the screenshot of one of the emails that was sent under the guise of being Stradman, and you focus in on the actual message that James put up on the screen, here's how that reads. The message says, "The Stradman interested in 26 2016 McLaren P1 GTR, Scotts Valley, United States. If you can do it under $2 million, he will definitely buy. After reading that through, it sounds like a younger person trying to sort of source hypercars toward James, obviously not understanding what they're doing. And now let's compare that to the message that I received. So just so you guys know, I actually receive a lot of messages like the one that we're about to show you, people trying to get in contact with Stradman because we talk about him so often on our channel. So here's the message that I received. It starts off by saying, I don't know if you were going to believe me, but in the Stradman latest video, it was me he was talking about, and he was right about me being still a kid. I'm only 13 and I made a really bad mistake that you should not have done. I think he meant to say I should not have done. I just hope he forgives me because I'm really sorry and won't do it again if it's possible. Can you tell him that if it ever happens again, it isn't me. I'm never going to do anything like that ever again. I'm sincerely sorry. He's my favorite YouTuber and I don't want to cause him any trouble. I just wanted to help. I never thought he was going to see it, but now that he has, already I'm feeling really bad and guilty for what I did. Please tell him that I'm sorry and won't do it again. Also, that if anyone else does it, it isn't me. So here's some of the reasons why I think this might actually be legitimate, although we can't verify that whatsoever. For one, something that sort of jumped out to me right away is that the way that James is referenced in both the message that James put up on his screen during his video and the message that I was sent is that James is referred to as the Stradman in both messages. So obviously there's a little bit of continuity between both supposed messages here referring to him in that way. The second reason is that this really does feel like it was written by a child. There's no real punctuation over the course of the entire message. They're apologizing, and the biggest one here is they're admitting fault here, which is not something that most people would do as a joke. If someone was trying to prank me through sending me this message on Instagram, it'd be kind of a weird thing to do. Obviously, if you watch James's video, he talks about legal ramifications if this sort of stuff doesn't stop or if they find out who's doing it. So you'd have to ask yourself, what sane adult would sort of interject themselves in that way by admitting fault to an automotive news and speculation outlet like our channel? If this happened to be a joke, it's not a very good one, and you're sort of implicating yourself in a legal matter. Not a very smart thing to do. Now, we did try to converse with the person that sent us this message, but they basically deleted their profile relatively soon after we started messaging them back, so no real leads there. The name of the Instagram account was like Instagrammer and basically disappeared very, very quickly. So there's no real leads in sort of going after and trying to find that because it doesn't exist anymore whatsoever. So if you're keeping tally, here's the takeaways from why we did this story. I thought it was just super weird and interesting, and there were so many question marks of why somebody would message me this particular thing. So I wanted to make sure I brought it to you guys because I thought it was just fascinating to sort of have to deal with. And obviously, it's a very big deal what James is going through with this person making offers on hypercars during his big search. And the other takeaway is this, guys. We hope that James's video really sort of resonated with whoever was actually doing this, that this child was sort of misguided in their trying to help James find a hypercar. And hopefully, if this was a true message, that this person will have seen James's video and will stop doing this sort of stuff that will interfere with his search. Anyway, that's all I've got, guys. I want to know what your thoughts are on this really weird identity theft situation. It's really strange to have to deal with, and I want to get your guys' take on it. So comment below what you thought about this whole thing. I want to throw it back to you. All right, guys, moving on to something kind of cool. We made a really weird prediction about 2 days ago about Daily Driven Exotics selling their C8 Corvette and then buying a Ford GT. And as of this morning, we are apparently right in our prediction based on all of Damon and Daily Driven Exotics' previous Instagram stories about selling the C8, buying a McLaren 720S. And after we saw that happen, we theorized that, you know, now that he had the 720S, the C8 was gonna be sort of kicked out of the fleet pretty soon. And that was all sort of verified this morning with Damon saying that the C8 is off to its new owner, talking about sort of the future of all of their different cars in that video. And it's kind of cool to make a prediction like that and have it turn true based off of really cool clues that were left over from the channel specifically. And I want to throw this back to you guys. First of all, do you think they're going to be buying a Ford GT now that the C8 is gone, like our sort of the second half of our prediction? And are you excited or bummed to see the C8 finally leave that fleet? Let me know in the comments below. Next up, guys, skimming through the rest of the news, News. Really, really cool story from Donut Media on the Suzuki Samurai. I feel like every day that I watch a Donut Media video, I just learn something incredibly new and interesting and sort of for fun trivia nights with all the car people that I know. Go watch this video, guys. Just a fascinating tale, sort of media spinning, crash tests, all that kind of jazz, and why the Suzuki Samurai ended up the way that it did. Go check it out, guys. Link in the description below. Savage Garage makes a really great appearance on Drag Times, the main focus of yesterday's video, potentially buying a Porsche 918 to add to his insane, super, and hopefully hypercar fleet. Awesome Koenigsegg CCX action with some awesome Huracan Evo action in there too. Make sure to go check it out, guys. Two fantastic channels that you should be really following. And skimming through the rest of the news, guys, we got some incredible 350Z action from Adam LZ with a little bit of fire too, if that's kind of your thing. F-Spot with his $12,000 exhaust impressing a cop, and I gotta tell you, this cop was one of the most knowledgeable cops I've ever seen. Obviously a car guy. Fascinating video if you've enjoyed F-Spot's $12,000 exhaust series. Doug DeMuro on the 2021 Mini Cooper JCW GP, a $50,000 Mini Cooper, if you can believe that. Awesome video from Doug DeMuro. Remove Before Race, the first look at the new 2021 Mercedes S-Class. I gotta tell you, this has some of the craziest crash technology that I've ever seen exist in a car. You gotta go check it out, guys. This is gonna be the future. A lot of cars going down the road. And last but certainly not least, guys, a major change from the Black Widow Supra channel. Getting rid of the Black Widow Supra in exchange for a 1998 Nissan Skyline R34. If you're a big fan of that car, go check out Black Widow Supra's channel. We'll put that in the links below. And folks, that's all I've got for you guys today, except to say that I had a really fantastic meeting this morning, talking with a shop here in Colorado Springs that is going to help me with my Raptor build and the stuff that we have planned for it. Ooh, I'm so excited about it. I can barely even contain it, but stay tuned for awesome vlogs. Gonna try to release one vlog a week to start. If you really like it, we'll do more. Probably on Sunday, the day that we normally don't do news. Anyway, have a fantastic day. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the channel. Make sure to stay safe, sane, and healthy, and we'll catch you later. I'm out of breath. Bye.